Today I'm gonna review the press lug for you. Servus, thanks for dropping in. Today I've got something really cool for you. Well, in fact I often do, but today it's really special. It is a slug press. So what are slugs? You'll see it later. They are pellets for air rifles. Not exclusively air rifles, but today it's about air rifles, of course. There are different calibers and they have a different shape than Diabolos, which leads to a different ballistic coefficient to shoot longer distances with high power. Slugs are mostly used for hunting. The hollow point has a different behavior on impact, which makes them useful for hunting. Yeah. We are not hunting with it in Germany, but if you want to shoot distances over 50, 70 or 100 yards, the slugs just have the better flight quality. Over the last years, a real hype built up around them, which also reached me, of course. right now, people want to shoot 4.5 caliber slugs with 7.5 Joule, which I would recommend only for PCP weapons. I am allowed to shoot high power rifles. Here, slugs really make sense with caliber 5.5, 6.35 and so on. Yeah, and you can shoot over larger distances then. Presslug is a company from the Czech Republic, which manufactures high quality equipment to build your own slugs. And now I'm asking myself, why should I build my own? I'll give you some reasons in the course of this video. The people that build their own ammunition among you will agree when I say that machine produced ammunition, or Diabolos in that case, often have minor variances, which of course often depend on the brand and so on. And here you have the chance to build your own with your chosen length, weight, and shape even, to perfectly match your own gun. Otherwise, you just have to go with what you can buy, while here you have a direct impact on it. The press lug set consists of three main components. You can't see the third right now. It's mounted on my workbench in the other room. And yeah, we'll of course go there with the cam later. The other two parts are here right in front of me. You can buy the press separately or in the full set plus any accessories at www.edgarnleschi.shop or www.hubenairguns.shop, which belong to my partner Wolfig Group. I will show you these two parts first, which you can have but don't necessarily need. The first part I'm showing you is this casting mold. I, for example, gather all my flattened used Diabolos and slugs, especially when I'm shooting outdoors, and put them in a bucket. At some point, I'm melting it all down, and then I can fill it right in here. The lead goes into these forms and can harden in it. And as soon as it is hard, I can remove the lead from the casting mold. If you won't melt your own lead, but you want to buy it as bulk stock, like here, you can use this cutter, which can be mounted to a workbench also for better handling. You just drill two holes so you can mount it properly, and then it's easier to handle. I did not mount it now, so I can show it to you a bit better. So yeah, in there you have this little container, Now you take your LED with 4.5, 5.5, 6.35 or 7.62 millimeter. Then you can set the length of the LED piece that you will cut off. That requires some testing. Maybe you don't have to use the full 15 millimeters to minimize waste when producing small slugs. I just tested around a bit, and depending on what I want to produce, I adapt the size in the front. I just set it to 10 millimeter now, and I'm working with caliber 6.35 because I made some slugs for my Edgun Leshy caliber 6.35 to shoot with 100 joule over 100 meters, which is a ton of fun. So just stick it in. One cut with the handle, it cuts both ways. Here the handling is a bit clunky for me, so I only cut one way. So that's how it works. The pieces drop out. It's super comfortable. I just produce a few, so we've got something to work with later. Now you have them in this small container down here. LED pieces with 10 millimeter length. I'd say we move the camera equipment to the other room now, and then we'll move on with the slug press. Here we are at the slug press. You see, here it is fully made of metal, and it is mounted with the screws coming along in the box. Now first, let's put the parts together. I'll probably have to block your view a little bit. Here on the side you find this wrench. It's super comfortable that all the tools are built into the press. I'll just fix this one here and then put the wrench back in its place. And for the upper one, I'll also fix this one with the wrench so it doesn't fall out. It's just a little bit, no force needed. Okay, up here I can, first of all, back here is a screw that I can open with this attached hex wrench. And now up here I can manipulate the length and thereby the weight of the slug continuously and super easy. I set the length now. I won't use this one, it's just to show it to you. I'm fixing it again and put the wrench aside. And now I take the first piece of lead that I cut a few minutes ago. Now I grab the lever and without any force move it down and back up again. You see that the excess lead comes out on the side. And that's what I meant before. If I keep on producing this slug size, I could now reduce the cut from 10 millimeter to maybe 8 millimeter, so I get less waste lead. Now I remove the slug and look at it and how highly precise it is crafted. I want to show you something now, but I'll produce a few more first. Zack, another one. Another one. One more maybe. Zack. Okay, now we have four slugs. I want to show you something now. I have a scale here. It is nothing fancy, not meant to measure if it is a thousandth gram heavier or not, but it is about the relation right now. I'm just grabbing some JSB knockout slugs, but you could take any other brand. 2.170, 2.191, 2.195, 2.191, 2.164, 63, 64 maybe, yeah. So there's definitely a spread just grabbing them from the box. And now I grab ours. Oh, funny, we almost produced the same weight. 2.177. That was not on purpose, absolutely random. 2.177. 2.174. 2.175, 76, 74, doesn't matter. You see the tolerance of my freshly produced slugs is around 3,000th, while with the others the tolerance was around 30,000th. This means this press produces the slugs extremely, extremely precise and repeatedly, one after the other. If you want to shoot super precise with this press, you have an advantage compared to bored slugs or machine produced slugs. I'm just opening one of these packs for you. That's what it looks like if you buy parts for another caliber. If you shoot caliber 4.5 exclusively, you don't need all this and can save that money. And now look again at these unbelievably cool slugs. I made these in caliber 6.35 with 2.46 gram and shot a 2.5 centimeter spread over 75 meters, 80 yards maybe, with my 101 joule Leshy 2. It is unbelievable what you can craft at home with this. Really, really cool. Okay, that's about it. You see a lifetime warranty sign here. I don't even know what could break on it. Made in Czech Republic, a really cool tool. And it is not only the precision you get from it, it is just super fun to build your own slugs before you head out to the shooting range. You know exactly what you get and have a superb quality for best results. Please follow my YouTube channels, the English one Air Gandhi World and the German one Air Gandhi. Especially on the English one, you will see more content with high-powered rifles where I also use slugs I crafted with the press slug, and you will see the extraordinary quality. Thank you all for watching. I hope you were entertained and I'll see you next time. Ciao, Servus, es ist Air Gandhi.